good, everybody. This banana kind of tastes a little funky. Hey, everybody. Thanks for stopping by for another video. That's enough. I think that at whatever kind of level of photography you're at, if you're a beginner, if you're a pro, I think it's important to get back to just kind of shooting around and leaving stuff up to chance. And not so much how you make it, but rather working with what you got type situation. That's why I really like to go over to New Smyrna Beach or any of the other beaches in Florida, because there's not much that I can change about what's going on there. It's a beach. There's only so many things that you can photograph, and there's only so many things that you can look at, but it's all about perspective, and it's all about how I view things versus what another photographer would see. I think that it's important for development of creativity. Say, for instance, you're like a commercial photographer, you know? There's definitely creativity that goes into commercial photography, but for the most part, it's not always your creativity. Or coming from working from Specialized, which is a multi-billion dollar company, we have creative directors, you know? We have people who call those types of shots, and it's up to us to shoot those things the way that they envision sometimes. Now, that doesn't happen all the time. You know, you're in that position because you have creativity. You're a photographer and you're a part of the team because you have the ability to make those decisions. But ultimately, if you're working for a big company, or maybe you're freelancing for commercial stuff like makeup or, you know, things like that, sometimes the creative direction isn't necessarily yours. So it's more about being a technical photographer and not so much being able to open up your creative juices and just letting them flow and everything. So I think it's important as a photographer to kind of let go of that for a day or two and just go out and shoot and see things the way that you want to see them and create images the way that you want to create them. And it's not up to anybody else to interpret except for you. And that's kind of the beautiful part of photography. So this video is going to be all about what I saw yesterday morning at New Smyrna Beach. And I hope that you guys enjoy, and I will catch you guys there. It's been a super, super cloudy morning. Not really much to it. Been pretty chilly, and there hasn't really been like a lot of sun out, which is totally fine. I knew that was going to happen. That's why I came. I wanted to create some more dramatic looking photos, and I think that we're doing that right now. There seems to be a good level of fog. The waves are really nice and blue. Hopefully we get some really cool shots, and yeah. so this is now my third time filming this stupid outro. All I wanted to say was thank you for tuning into the video, but my camera wants to tell me that the SD card is full, and then the first time, I didn't even hit the record button, so I'm just sitting here talking to myself like a dumb idiot boy. I just feel like an idiot. So, to reiterate what I've been saying for the past 10 minutes, and I need to try and remember what I was saying so that it sounds good. Thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you guys for tuning into the video. I had a lot of fun shooting yesterday morning with Athena. She kind of tagged along. It was her first time at the beach. She didn't really mess with the water like that. Wasn't really her shtick. That's okay. Hopefully you guys got to see a little bit of what I see whenever I go out on one of these shoots and just kind of shoot around and let myself be present in the environment that I'm in. Like I said before, I think it's really important as a photographer to kind of challenge yourself to just create things with what you're given and not so much about creating a production. There will be a lot more videos like this in the future just because I do this quite often, and I think it's a good exercise for photographers of all levels to do. I think that it's really important that you kind of embrace that creativity and let those juices flow, because like I said before, that's really what photography is all about. So my next video will be posted on Saturday. Yes, Saturday. So hopefully you guys go and check out that video. Again, thank you so much for checking out my first video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the second one, and I will have all of these photos up on my Instagram very soon. You guys can check out the new photos on Instagram at any time. I post every day. A lot of the captions and everything are stories that I've written, or just me telling my experience and what I was thinking during these shoots. So hopefully you guys can learn a little bit about my artistic process through that too. If you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, literally anything, if you just want to say hi, you can hit me down in the comments, you can hit me on Instagram, follow, do whatever, that whole shtick. I'm not gonna say all that stuff because it's annoying. So thank you guys again for tuning in, and I'll see you guys on Saturday. Peace out.